Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadha Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Can you check Mr. Mr. Ekadashi is there? So that person would say okay, he would just make a feeling that he is searching. After 5 minutes, if Ekadashi is not here, he will come back on Saturday. Let me tell you, that was the trick we used to use. That time was a really tight budget. So, you know, anyway, but in the meanwhile, when he was checking, this devotee would keep on saying, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. In America, that's difficult. Now, the operator has to keep the phone on because that other party has gone to search. The operator is connecting the two parties. The night that person says Ekadashi will come on Saturday, so this call he will not be charged because he has not accepted, he has to say yes. So till that time you can do whatever you like. So you got the news of Ekadashi, plus he chanted 2-3 mantras also. So that's why Prabhupada said this Hari Bol system. You know, Hare Krishna. I think hi, hello, Hare Krishna. It's a great win. Can you imagine how many people are saying Hare Krishna? Even those who are against Hare Krishna, like Prabhupada's Guru Maharaj, Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur, and you won't hear, there's some news article about the Gaudiya Mutt. Some reports about the Gaudiya Mutt. And there were two articles. So, one article was derogated, criticizing the activities of the Mutt. And the other article was praising the Mutt. So they brought Guru Maharaj, two newspapers are there, and one is saying good things about our mission, and the other is criticizing the mission. So, which is better? So, he said, count how many times the name Krishna comes. So, in the good article, the name of Krishna was there 2 times. But in the article criticizing, the name was there 10 times. So, Bhaktivinoda said, this is a better article. Because 10 times the name and 10 lakh people will read. So, 100 lakh times the name of Krishna. So we'll pause any questions or comments. As I said, it's more of a discussion class. Anybody would like to share something? Okay. Now we have the choice. Now we have had about 20 minutes of class. Now should we continue with this or should we go to the book of chanting Hare Krishna? What would the Vaishnavas like to hear more? There that's hints about chanting. Yeah, this is more of a discussion. Huh? Chanting. Okay. That was my choice also. So, in the morning I took the chapter. Actually, by the way, these 10 books have been ordered so far. As I said, this the one with 250 rupees is not available. We have a cheaper edition. Same content. So, Nandana Acharya Prabhu is going to Pune, where the books are available. So those of you like, you can give your names. Money can be given later on. So that Prabhuji will bring on 14th of October. Okay. One chapter we covered was how we become free from offenses. Right? Another important chapter is the chanting in a humble state of mind. Actually, that chanting in the humble state of mind. In fact, for this process of chanting the humble state of mind, we will be covering tomorrow because in that there is the discussion. I was having a seminar on the holy name by Lord Chaitanya. We will discuss it tomorrow because I'm expecting more audience tomorrow morning, Saturday morning. But for now, I want to take the chapter of perfection of chanting, or chanting at the time of death. This is very important. Chanting is a time of death. Please repeat after me. Antakale shamameva.
Antakale shamameva.
Saran mukva kalevaram.
Saran mukva kalevaram.
Vayadhi samadbhavam. The translation, everybody knows, this is the 8th chapter. Whoever quotes his body, remembering me, he will attain me. Of this there is no doubt. The Prabhupada explaining in the purport here that whatever we are thinking of at the time of death, that will determine our next destination. So, Krishna is the supreme pure. So if you remember the Param Pavitra, you also become pure. Just like iron is put in a fire, then gradually the iron will develop the quality of the fire. The iron is cold, it cannot affect. But if the iron is kept in the fire, then gradually it will develop the quality of the fire. And then anybody who touches that iron rod, he will get the same effect of touching the fire. So, Krishna is a supreme fire. Krishna's name is Supreme Fire. A devotee who is constantly chanting Hare Krishna, he will also become godly. We cannot become God, but we can become godly. And then anybody who comes into contact with that person, he will also start chanting Hare Krishna. So chanting in association is so important. So tomorrow we are planning that we will really Bhagavatam class from 8 to 9:30. And then maybe after 10 o'clock, we will be doing extra japa. For those of you like. Now you may say, Prabhuji, I can do at home also. What is the use of chanting here? But when we chant in the association of devotees, then the effect is many times more powerful. Especially when we chant in having darshan of the deities of Lord Jagannath, praying for their mercy, the effect is even more powerful. So, there's a story in Chaitanya Charitamrita that one devotee whose name was Garuda Pandita. Have you heard this story? Garuda Pandita. Garuda Pandita was very advanced devotee. And he was traveling in the jungle. And as he was going in the jungle, suddenly big serpent came, like a python. Now you are awake, no? Okay, I was just to look, make you up. And many others. So this serpent came and just put his, you know how the serpents they attack. They don't give you notice, you know. Hari Bol, I'm attacking you. Be ready. Mahaprasadi Govinde. No. No prayers offered. After you are killed, then the prayers will be there. So that serpent just bit him. And although Garuda Pandit was a great devotee, but by the will of the Lord, the snake's poison became effective. His whole body turned black. Has any of you been bitten by a scorpion or a snake? No? You're very fortunate. No? I got this mercy once. Few years back when I was in Khirchur Gopinath, one scorpion bit me. The effect is very painful. It's like somebody is putting a needle inside your body and taking it out and again. And snake bite is worse than scorpion. His whole body became black and he was in the jungle. There's no question of a doctor or a physician. So he just had full faith in Krishna. He just went on, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare, 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 Ram, 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 Hare, Hare. So loudly started chanting. And by Krishna's mercy, the poison effect was gone. It was like an antidote. We generally don't recommend this. It's not that we say, oh, chant Hare Krishna for removing poison. Or if you are not getting a job, chant 32 rounds, you will get a job. Chant 64 rounds, you will get a high post, you know. We don't use for this purpose. To try to chant the holy name for material purpose is an offense. But this comes as a side effect, just by the power of the name. And there's another great devotee, whose name is Saranga Thakur. How many of you have heard the story of Saranga Thakur? No? You must have heard, no? You have not heard? Saranga Thakur Katha Sune? Saranga Thakur, Prabhuji ki tarah Hindi mein bol raha hu. Saranga Thakur, wo Bengal mein rehte the. Mayapur ke paas, Mududrum Dweep. Dekha aapne? Mamgachi. Mamgachi ke? Wahan pe Saranga Thakur ka sthan hai.
सारंग ठाकुर को चैतन्य महाप्रभु बोले आप प्रचार करो, हरि नाम प्रचार करो, दीक्षा दो। ओ नहीं 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 नहीं, हम क्वालिफाइड नहीं है, आई एम नॉट क्वालिफाइड। लॉर्ड टोल्ड हिम गिव दीक्षा, आई एम नॉट क्वालिफाइड। फाइनली सेड आई एम ऑर्डरिंग यू, जस्ट गो एंड प्रीच, प्रचार करो। द नेक्स्ट डे वो गए और उनको एक छोटा बच्चा दिखाई पड़ा, स्मॉल चाइल्ड ही सॉ, हु हैड ऑलरेडी बीन बिटन बाय अ स्नेक एंड वाज डेड। उसका मृत्यु हो गया था सांप के काटने से। तो बंगाल में एक प्रथा है, किसी का डेथ हो जाए अगर सांप के काटने से, तो उसको गंगा जी में बहा देते हैं। दे डोंट बर्न हिम, दे जस्ट पुट हिम इन द गंगा। तो सारंग ठाकुर देखे समथिंग इज कमिंग, ओके, वो छोटा बच्चा है उसके पास में, उसके कान में हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, बस। और बच्चा एकदम खड़ा हो गया, ही केम बैक टू लाइफ एंड सेड हरि बोल। आप इतना धीरे बोल रहे हैं, हरि बोल। सपोज आप मर गए और किसी ने जिंदा किया तो कितना खुश होंगे, नहीं? आपको विश्वास नहीं होता तो होगा आपके साथ देख लेते हैं ना, यू आर डेड एंड समबडी डिवोटी कम्स एंड यू गेट अप हरि बोल, ओह वेरी गुड, आई हैड टू स्पेशल, यस आई गॉट एसोसिएशन अगेन। सो वो बच्चा उनके साथ ही रहने का, वो बच्चा वापस घर नहीं गया, ही स्टेड विद सारंग ठाकुर। देन हिज पेरेंट्स केम एंड सेड ओ दिस मुरारी, हिज नेम वॉज माई सन, ही इज माई सन, ये हमारा बेटा है, आश्रम में कैसे पहुंच गया, कैसे बीटीए में आ गया है ना, ये कैसे आ गया। तो सारंग ठाकुर, आपकी इच्छा है तो आप ले जाओ, आप पूछो इनको जाना है तो, बेटे चलो चलो घर चलो। बोला नहीं नहीं, मेरी तो मृत्यु हो गई थी, इन्होंने मुझे जिंदा किया, इसलिए यही मेरे पिता है, यही मेरे गुरु है। ही वॉज डेड बट बाई सारंग ठाकुर होली नेम ही गॉट अप एंड देन द चाइल्ड to remain with Sarangatha. So many stories are there, power of the Holy. But here Prabhupada is saying most important is smaranam. If you do shravan and kirtan nicely, it will lead to smaranam. Whatever you hear and chant, that is what you will remember at the time of death. What is the most attached? Just like why this advertising industry works, you know, they have this ads coming in newspaper, even in phones, mobiles also. Shravanam Kirtanam Mayanam, not Vishnu, Shravanam Kirtanam Maya. So at the end of life we should remember Krishna. Ante Narayana Smriti. So one devotee asked this question, Maharaj, you are saying that we should remember Krishna at the time of death. So why should we chant now? It is the time of death, we'll say Hare Krishna. We know the password. Bhagavan ka naam अंत समय में याद करना जरूरी है, तो अभी से नाम लेने की क्या जरूरत है रेवती रमन प्रभु? सुना आपने प्रश्न, जवाब दे। हाँ लेना भूल जाएंगे, जल्दी आएंगे ज़्यादा याद आएगा। एक्चुअली प्रभु जी ऑफिस में थे 6:30 तक, और मैंने फ़ोन किया था सब ऑफिस छोड़ के सर्वधर्मान परित्यज केम रनिंग, दैट इज एंथुसियाज्म। मैंने उनको बोला आप बॉस को बोल के आना, बोले मेरे बॉस कृष्ण है, जगन्नाथ है, दैट इज द स्पिरिट। तो प्रभु जी वेरी राइटली सेड इफ यू डोंट प्रैक्टिस नाउ देन इट इज़ वेरी डिफिकल्ट। जस्ट लाइक चिल्ड्रन, यू सेंड अवर चिल्ड्रन टू कोचिंग क्लासेस और स्कूल, जनरली एग्जाम इज इन मार्च और अप्रैल। श्री गोपीनाथ प्राणपुर, वेन इज एग्जाम? प्रभु जी भूल गए, वो भी ग्रेजुएट हो गए, डॉक्टर भी वो ग्रेजुएट हो गए, अभी नाउ इज रिमेंबरिंग कृष्ण। यू रिमेंबर वन विच मंथ एग्जाम्स आर देर? हाँ जून, जून जुलाई, प्रभु जी को याद भी नहीं है। मार्च, सो ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड, सो नाउ मार्च अप्रैल इज द फाइनल एग्जाम। व्हाई डू वी स्टार्ट, व्हेन डू वी स्टार्ट द स्कूल्स, इन जुलाई और अगस्त? मे इटसेल्फ। व्हाई? वी कैन स्टार्ट इन वन मंथ बिफोर द एग्जाम ना, बिकॉज वी वांट द चिल्ड्रन शुड गेट गुड मार्क्स। If you just start preparing 1 month, there are some students, hi-fi students, they ask just 1 week before exam, what is the syllabus? So, but that student, they may not pass the exam. So you have to start prepare well in advance. And when is our final exam? Generally death. Death will come after the age of 60, right? Or 70? Huh? How much?
We should think
anytime. Koi notice nahi aata. At least in Maharashtra there is no notice. Maybe Karnataka has different rules. Anytime. Actually, very unfortunate incident took place. I was going from Bombay to Pune just last weekend to see my mother. Because I saw my mother, I took her to. Now she is in good health because of the prayers of all you devotees. She can walk with a cane. She had made a vow that on Janmashtami I will go to temple walking. And Krishna fulfilled her desire and with the prayers of the devotees. So after she had darshan, then the car went back to Pune. Of course, I stayed in Bombay. As the car was returning, there was another car which was with one doctor. And three doctors were there. And the car just stopped. There was a flat tire. So this one very famous spine doctor. And he was helping to change the tire. The car was stationary. And just some bus came and slammed. And they had very unfortunate death. Now what was his fault? He's just standing on the side, changing the tire. And the doctor was so, like, generally the doctor is not supposed to help in this, the duty of the driver. But he was thinking, let me help him. He was sitting down, like, in the side of the main road. Destiny is very powerful. And first today, I want to also take this opportunity to, the last kirtan I want to dedicate to one very nice Vaishnavi. One devotee is my very good friend, Ananta Vilas Prabhu. He got initiated just last week in Chicago. And I saw him in Vrindavan. He's working in the US. So I asked him why Vrindavan. So he says that his wife, only 38 years old, has got fourth stage cancer. And very painful. So he was requesting me that in the evening in your program, please pray for her. I have not, just before coming from Vrindavan, I met her. One good thing, although she is in pain, you know, so much painful, she knows she has to live in maximum 6 months, 1 year, or maximum 2 years. And he's got one young son, 3 years old, a daughter, 10 years old. But when I met her first time, I said, I'm praying for you. So she said, just pray that I can remember Krishna. And she got introduced to Krishna consciousness in America. She is Indian body, Bengali family. So, what we can understand is, nothing can be said here. This is just 37-year-old. One case we know, young boy, 21 years old. So, what is the guarantee? You may say that I will become serious after the age of 35, after the age of 45. There is no guarantee. Today, I mean, I just may go to the room and never get up in the morning. Sometimes, you know, when you do a medical checkup, suddenly you find you have some very grave disease. So that's why Prabhupada is saying that we should practice from beginning of life. So now you may say, Prabhuji, I know these things, they are very old points, but are we really following it? Do we have that feeling that I may die any moment? Very few of us are actually feeling like this. What is that famous verse? What is the greatest wonder of the world? Not Taj Mahal or the Leaning Tower. What is the greatest, most wonderful thing in the world? Ahani ahani bhutani gacchanti yamale. We see people around dying, but we feel that I will not die. So, Draupadi is saying here, we should constantly, incessantly chant the Maha Mantra. What does constantly mean? Always. And incessantly means? Always. Why does Prabhupada write in one sentence this word? This is in the eighth chapter of Bhagavad Gita. He is saying one should constantly, incessantly chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Just to emphasize. You know, जैसे हम किसी को हिंदी में बोलते हैं ना, ये प्रसाद का प्लेट मेरे लिए बनाना, पक्का बनाना, नक्की बनाना, हाँ, मेरे लिए दो गुलाब जामुन रखना. बार-बार बोलते हैं, इसे please make a plate of prasad for me. Rithiram likes gulab jamun, gulab jamun. So why do we have two times? Rithiram Prabhu, do bar kyun bolte hain? Haan, uspe jod lagane ke liye. Yes, I have to. That's why Prabhupada is saying, constantly remember. That is why I am making this endeavor, taking inspiration from other devotees in other parts of Bangalore and India. This world, holy name, week we are celebrating. Actually, we should try to chant every day little extra rounds. At least, I would say, if you are chanting 16, you can chant 32. 32 is not difficult. Just have to chant 32 and then again 30, another 16 and 16, that is 32. So if you see 32, it looks very fearful. How can I chant? So just chant 16. Then after a pause, chant another 16. That is 32. Then another 32, that makes it 64. So psychologically, you feel that it's very difficult. Oh, how can I do it? So tomorrow, what we are planning is we will chant 16 rounds in the morning from 5:30 to 7:30, there is japa session. So we can easily finish 16 rounds. Then darshanarti, then class. I'll try to start the class early at 8 o'clock with your cooperation and blessings. And after that class, maybe a little breakfast, and then we will chant more. And we can continue till 12:30. Is it possible? How many would like to join tomorrow? At least you can join for 1 hour, 2 hours, or if possible, all 4 hours. Or if you have to go to your office, you can go and continue there. So unless we make a discipline, we will not get that taste. We will become senior. Like now, I am so senior. Practically, more than half of my life, I have been a full-time today. I am 57 and 35 years, I have been in bhakti. But still, I do not get taste. Some people tell me, Prabhuji, you have got a lot of taste. I don't have taste. But only good thing, I push myself and I push others. The advantage of pushing others is you have to push yourself also. Now, if I tell all of you how to chant, then obviously I have to also sit and chant. Otherwise, my words will not have effect. Just like a child has the potency to learn, but the mother or the father have to sit with the child. Remember? When your daughter was younger in the other apartments, I used to come sometimes to sit with her and make sure that they finish the lesson. Children will run away sometimes in between. But later on, they become very good students. You also agree, Prabhuji? Your son, you have to sit with the child. The mind is like a child. Mind is not cooperative. But without the mind's cooperation, we cannot chant also. We cannot say, okay, mind, you go wherever you like, I will sit and move the fingers. It's not detachable hard disk, you know. It is part of the CPU. It's inside the same chip is there. Mind intelligence integrated, VLSI. So the mind has to cooperate. That's why we have to be patient. Wherever the mind goes, bring it back. Wherever the mind goes, bring it back and here. And in between, when you have great difficulty, just stop. Fold your hands before Guru Maharaj, Prabhupada and Lord Jagannath. Please help me, my Lord. I am trying to chant, but my mind is wandering. You could kill the demon Trinavarta, who came in the form of whirlwind. Trinavarta, kitna bada tufan. We heard about this. Funny. In Odisha, there was a storm, you know. Funny. And then this time Gujarat also, and like in America, you heard about this. In Gujarat also, there have been storms in America, Katarina, Rita, so many. They call hurricane. But more powerful than hurricane is Hari name. Holy name is more powerful. All these storms together cannot equal to Trinavarta. But Krishna could kill Trinavarta in no time. So no matter how turbulent our mind may be, we should go on chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. So Prabhupada says here, you have to practice chanting. And how did the test, what is the test that whether we have chanted nicely or not, when is the test going to take place? At the time of death. Bhajan kare, sadhan kare, marte jan. Yes. You speak Bengali?
Yes.
From Bengali? Bengalis know how to pronounce properly. You know? So, at the time of death, it will be tested. And there is no notice also. I remember when I was a student in Banaras, sometimes, you know, exams was on Thursday. Then Tuesday, we would go to the professor and say, please, you know, can you postpone it? Because, you know, we are not prepared. And then we would take some rasgulla, mahaprasad for him. And then eating the rasgulla, he would become very kind. He was from Bengali also. That. But here we cannot give rasgulla to Yamaraj. Please postpone my exam. So what Yamaraj will say, okay, come in Yamaloka, we have more rasgullas for you. Different kind of rasgullas, you know. So we cannot postpone. I know one case in Bombay, one One rich man was saying, "Doctor Saab, I'll give you 10 lakh rupees, just postpone by 1 year. I want to finish some document writing to take care of my children's." The doctor said, "Even I can't change. And cancer is so widespread nowadays, become so rampant. Even dengue is so unreliable. Dengue is even more dangerous because you have no prediction. Cancer at least you come to know. But dengue is can just kill you in no time. Even devotees, sometimes they have." So Prabhupada says here, we should continue to chant. At the end of life, Krishna will help you. Now you may say, Prabhuji, okay, I am trying, but what is the guarantee? At the time of death, suddenly I may remember pizza, or I may remember my family members. Prabhupada says, if you are sincerely tried whole life, then Krishna will help you. Because Krishna is the examiner, setter, he is the corrector also. Even if you don't, I have not written the answer, if the examiner is your good friend, you know, then he can give you full marks. There is a very nice prayer which I found in one letter by Prabhupada to Devananda Pandit Prabhu. This different Prabhupada disciple Devananda. He says, please repeat this prayer. Oh my dear Lord, you are sitting in my heart. From you comes knowledge, remembrance and forgetfulness. Please grant me that I may always remember your holy name and never forget. You may put me into hell. That does not matter. But wherever I am, let me remember your holy name. So please, once again in your mind, repeat this prayer. Praying to Lord Jagannath, please help me remember all the time and especially at the moment of death. Hare Krishna. This reminds me of the final days of Srila Prabhupada. How many of you seen this video of Prabhupada's, that final, what is that called, final lesson? Have you seen that video, final lesson? Yes, see? If you have not seen, you can copy from my laptop this video. You have got at home, that final lesson, video? Nowadays, you get a pen drive, you know. That is the lesson when Prabhupada was in last days in Vrindavan. You find the devotees are carrying him. The Charanamrita has to be put in the mouth directly, you know, last this. And what was Prabhupada's response? You know what Prabhupada said? Prabhupada told the devotees, "Do not think that this will not happen to you. You should be ready." Although Prabhupada was in, obviously there is pain, obviously the body is deteriorated, but Prabhupada was very grave and sober. He was dhira, undisturbed. During his last moments, he was translating Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto. Very, very clearly, he was repeating the message of Krishna. Prabhupada traveled all over the world, but in the final stage, he came to Vrindavan. The Prabhupada said, we should also go anywhere where Krishna sends us, but our heart should be in Vrindavan. Of course, we don't know where we will leave our body. That choice is not enough. But we should pray to Krishna that if possible, I would like to leave my body following Haridas Thakur. How Haridas Thakur, when he had to leave the world, he told Lord Chaitanya, "I don't want to see the final chapter of your Leela. I don't want to see your Tirobhav. Before you leave the world, I want to leave. And I want to be surrounded by devotees. I want to put your lotus feet on my chest. I want to behold like your moon-like form. And with my tongue, I want to chant Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Shri Krishna Chaitanya." And Lord Chaitanya told him, "Haridas, don't speak like this. What are you saying? Do you not know? I have come to this world just to be with devotees like you. If you leave the world, then what will I do here?" Haridas caught hold of the Lord's lotus feet and said, "Oh my Lord, please do not speak like this. You have got hundreds of devotees who are fit to sit on my head. Ramanand Rai, Sarvamattacharya, Swarup Damodar. I am like a small ant. If an ant dies, what is the loss to the world? My Lord, please fulfill my desire." You are known as Bhakta Vatsala, that one who fulfills the desires of his devotees. I am not even a Bhakta. I am a Bhakta Abhas. The Nama Bhas, Bhaktan Bhaktabhas means I am an imitation devotee. Yet, my Lord, please, if it so pleases you, please fulfill my desire. Whenever we pray to Krishna also, we should not be praying in the mood of ordering, but we can pray with a humble heart, if you so desire. Like I remember when I was fortunate to meet Prabhupada in 1977, in the month of March. At that time, Prabhupada was quite healthy, but within a few minutes, within a few months, his health deteriorated. Then we were all sending messages to Prabhupada, and we asked Prabhupada, can we offer prayers for you? Prabhupada said, yes, you can keep a picture of Lord Narasimhadev and pray, O Lord Narasimhadev, if you so desire, please cure Srila Prabhupada. This was our daily prayer in all his contemples during the final pastimes of Srila Prabhupada. When Haridas Thakur said like this, please fulfill my desire, Lord Chaitanya was speechless. How can he refuse the prayer of such a loving, sincere devotee who was willing to sacrifice his life, being beaten in 22 marketplaces brutally? Just he was doing all this just to spread the message of Krishna. I mean, I am very enthusiastic in preaching. Many of us, suppose we are told after preaching, you will be beaten in 2 marketplaces. So we will say, okay, Prabhuji, I will hand over the program to another devotee. I am not qualified, you know. Because we know after lecture we get some respect, most of the time there is good prasadam. So we are eager to preach. I am talking about myself, I am a neophyte devotee. But suppose I am tested like this, that with every preaching you are beaten, then it will be very hard to continue preaching. But Jesus Christ and Haridas Thakur, Prabhupada gives 2 examples of devotees who are so tolerant. That's why they could chant all that. The greatness of a person is in his ability to tolerate provoking situations. So Prabhupada always gives the example of Haridas Thakur and Jesus Christ. So then Lord Chaitanya said, I have some duties to do, I will come back tomorrow. The next day he brought his whole party, Kirtan party, Swarup Damodar, Vakreshwar Pandit. Vakreshwar Pandit was such a good dancer. He could dance for how many hours? You know, 2 hours? 72 hours. Most of us cannot dance for 2 hours also. Né? Very difficult to dance. And it was non-stop. Like he started dancing, he started dancing. Today is Friday. He could dance till Monday evening, 7 p.m. Hare Krishna. He came. And then Lord Chaitanya came very near and asked, Haridas, what is the news? Haridas smiled and with folded hands he said, whatever mercy you want to show, I will accept. The Lord told Swarup Damodar to start singing. Lord himself started glorifying Haridas Thakur. He spoke about Haridas Thakur as if he had 5 mouths. Or some places it says thousands of mouths. Haridas Thakur was so humble. He took the dust of the lotus feet of all the assembled devotees. And all the devotees were so happy to hear the glorification of Haridas Thakur. They were not feeling envious. Why is he being glorified? I am senior to him. They were happy. And Haridas Thakur took the dust of all the devotees. And then he called Lord Chaitanya to come near. He placed the lotus feet of Lord Gaurahari on his chest. And with his eyes he was beholding the moon-like face of Lord Gaurasundar. And with his lips he was chanting, Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Shri Krishna Chaitanya. And remembering the beautiful names of the Lord, he departed to join the Lord in his eternal spiritual life. Lord Chaitanya was so much in ecstasy. He took the transcendental body of Haridas Thakur. The soul had left, but he was dancing with the body for a long time. And the devotees explained, my Lord, it's time for the other rituals also. They carried the body of Haridas on a palanquin. It was so beautiful, it looked like an airship. And they came to the bank of the ocean, Swargadwar, and they bathed the transcendental body of Haridas with water, and Lord Chaitanya drank that water. He was swimming in that water. He said, this place, this part of the ocean is Mahatirtha, because Haridas Thakur has been bathed here. Then Lord Chaitanya built a samadhi. He got the rope from the Rath Yatra. He got flowers from Jagannath. He got the Mahaprasad and the Chandan and the cloth of Lord Jagannath. Then he put the sand and he was chanting, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. Then he went personally with his chadar in his hand and went to all the shopkeepers. I am begging alms for the Tirobhav of Haridas Thakur. The shopkeepers were giving big, big baskets. But Sarvadamodar said, my lord, it's not proper for you. You sit down and take prasad. Here are four devotees, they will go. And he told the devotees, don't ask for more, just one palmful. There are so many shopkeepers. Lord Chaitanya said, all right, if I am not going to beg, I will serve the prasad. The devotee should be very eager to do any service. Sometimes we cook prasad and somebody says, after cooking, you have to serve also. He says, Prabhuji, I have done my job. This is another department. But Haridas, I'm sorry, Lord Chaitanya, he was begging prasad, then he was serving prasad. And then Mahaprabhu would not give little bit. Mahaprabhu haste alpana aise, eka eka patalera panchajanera parose. Mahaprabhu served in such a way that on each patal, he gave prasad equal to 5 people. This is how we should eat today. Once physically and 4 mentally. And then Lord Chaitanya, after serving prasad, he personally garlanded each devotee. He garlanded each devotee, put chandan, applied chandan, sandalwood pulp to all the devotees. And then he said, Haridas Thakur, the crest jewel of all devotees. The earth is now bereft of his divine association. When Haridas wanted to leave, it was not within my power to stop him from leaving. He left by his own sweet will, as who had left? Bhishmadev, yes. Bhishmadev. And then Lord Chaitanya started glorifying. He said, Jai Jai Haridas. Sab mili gaye jaya jaya Haridas. Namera mahima je korila prakasha. Everyone chanted Jai Jai Haridas because he glorified the holy name. Then Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told the devotees. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written one nice saying in the Samadhi of Haridas. You know what is that? He reasons ill who says that Vaishnavas died. Somebody says that Vaishnava is died. That is wrong. Why? When thou art still living in sound. In sound, in the Vani. Prabhupada said, I will not die. I am there in my books. This is sound. Now we are reading from Prabhupada's books. Means we are with Prabhupada. Don't think that Prabhupada is far away. When you are reading his books, he is there with you. When Vaishnava died to live, and while living, spread the holy name around. So this is Vaishnava. And then Lord Chaitanya, he said, Haridas is a Parama Vidwan. What does the word Vidwan mean? Scholar. He's called Param Vidwan, topmost scholar. Why? There are many other scholars who are better than him. He was not such a great Pandit. He didn't write many books. But why is Lord Chaitanya calling Haridas Thakur a Parama Vidwan? Because he knew the Vidya of chanting Hare Krishna, of crossing over the cycle of birth and death. Anybody who knows how to cross the cycle of birth and death, he is the greatest scholar. It's like, you know the story of that boatman and that scholar. Scholar asking so many questions. And the boatman did not know. You don't know about politics, 25%. You don't know about chips. He said, no, I don't know. I know banana chips and potato chips. He said, you don't know 50% life gone. You don't know about the latest vehicles. 75% life gone. And then suddenly, rainfall, storm, boat was about to drown. And the professor, he was terrified. What man, what will happen? Don't worry, sir. We are very nearby. We can just swim this half kilometer. Swimming, oh, they didn't teach me in IIT swimming. So you don't know swimming, then 100% life is gone. So it's gone. We have different skills like giving lecture, cooking, dressing the deity, managing. They are all like the different vidyas. But chanting is like swimming. If you have learned all of these things, but you have not learned to chant properly, then at the time of death, the pralaya will come and you will have to take another birth. So one devotee was asking me, actually he was asking in Pune, he was asking his fullness, Radhanath Maharaj. Maharaj, you always encourage that we should chant more and serve with more sincerity in a humble mood so that we can go back to Godhead in this life. But what is the difference whether we go back to Godhead in one life or after two lives? Your abode is fixed, your seva is fixed, nobody occupies your birth. You know, why should we struggle so much to chant more with more intensity and try to go back to God in one life? Yes, anybody like to answer? Jaldi jane kya jarurat hai, ne? Bhagwan ke dhami jane, durghatna se der bhali, slow and steady wins the race. Yes. How do you explain this, Raviti Raman Prabhu? Any of the Matajis would like to try? Yes, Govinda Sundar Prabhu. Does it make a difference whether you go back to only one life or 10 lives? Yes. As long as you don't go back, you take birth again. That means death. Again going in the mother's womb. Very crowd, very jam-packed. Of course, some of you have experience in Bombay locals, you get some idea. If somebody can travel in Bombay local trains, he can travel any part of the world. It's like getting in like Mahabharat, fast local, you know. Getting out is very easy, you just stand and people will lovingly push you out. You have been there, Niminathu? No? You are fortunate. But that is nothing compared to mother's womb, because at least there are not obnoxious things around you. You know? But in the mother's womb, you are surrounded by all the, you know, whether man's body, woman's body, inside it's all same. There is bones and stool and urine and blood and there are worms biting. The child actually prays, please take me out. I promise you I will become your devotee. All of you made this promise. All of those who came from mother's womb, majority, I mean all of you. We made this promise. But when we come out, and then everybody says, happy birthday to you. And that's the end of our... Then whenever I see like, you know, little children, Krishna's mercy, there are no little babies in the room today. The babies, they cry, they disturb the program. So I was thinking, I don't want to disturb another program, you know. If I take birth again, some great soul Mataji will have to tolerate for 9 months and then again race. Again I go to school, Baba, Black Sheep and ABCD and, you know, by that time we don't know what will happen. Because previously when I got admission, I was 4 years old. Then now it's 3.5 years old admission, 2.5. And I heard some places they take admission when the child in the womb also. Whether boy or girl will decide later. But you can start getting, and a child is learning. Actually, from what I learned from one devotee, the child in the womb, he hears, he understands. When he takes birth, he forgets. But inside the womb, he has understanding power. A very interesting story. There are two. One family I always visit in Vrindavan, my good friend Radha Kant Prabhu. He is about maybe 35 years old. He has two sons. One son is Vishwambar, elder one. When he was born, I was not so much, I was not in Vrindavan. The second child, when the mother's womb, last year there was Adhik Mas, you know, in the month of May. So I was doing classes in different homes. And this family, they requested, since the child in the womb, so please do the class in our home. So 30 days we had evening 1 hour katha. So this little boy, whose name is now Vaman, who was inside the womb, he was hearing. And you will not believe me, but his behavior is completely different from the elder child. He is very, very gentle and eager to hear. The elder child is good also, but he is very naughty and, you know, he's just He wants to do what he wants to do. And I don't know whether it's by chance or arrangement, whenever he sees me, he just smiles. He wants to come near me. And generally children want to go near their mother or father. But when the child has been hearing, there is an effect. So, all of you know this, so we always try to give the child in the womb. But at the same time, we should try to avoid ourselves going in the womb again. Because it's too much. Then again, school, by the time, now there is so much, you know, education, educating a child is a challenge. What to speak if you are born again means like say 20 years from now or 30 years, education will be more polluted. Then somebody like Swayam Prakash Prabhu will come to the college and into some DYS course. Then he will ask, what is your name, who are you? That, oh, this is the Krishnanand from last life. You know, he was telling others to chant, but not chanting himself. So we don't want to come back again. That's why Prabhupada says, when Srila Jayapada Swami Maharaj wrote a letter to Prabhupada, in Mayapur he wrote a letter, Prabhupada, I am in Bengal now, I want to study Bengali. I need your blessings. Prabhupada said, good, you can study if you like. But in my opinion, if you have extra time, better to chant Hare Krishna more and more. Rather than study Bengali, you chant more rounds. Why? Because death can come any time, and before death comes, we have to attain final perfection. Samajh mein aaya aapko? Prabhupada ji, Jayapada Swami Maharaj ko letter likhe, ki aapko Bangla sikhna hai, aapka aashirwaad chahiye Bangla. Tab Prabhupada ji, Bangla sikho, galat nahi hai. Lekin jyada time mil raha hai, to chanting karna jyada important hai. Nahi to khali Bangla sikhe, japa achha nahi kiya, to fir agar se janam ho jayega Bengali family mein. You know, the chanting karna jyada important. Okay, we'll stop for 2 minutes for any comments or questions. Yes, Prabhu. Mind wanders. What?
By seeing a movie, or by watching a movie, we never wonders, concentrate
on the movie. What is the reason? While chanting, the mind wanders. While seeing a movie, it doesn't wander. While eating prasad also, it doesn't wander. Even while driving a car, it will not wander. You sit here, even my lecture, your mind may not wander so much. But when you put your hand in the beat bag, Jai Shri Jagat Chaitanya Prabhu, 30,000 feet. Confirmed, see? Prabhu Shankar Vada Tirtha Chaitanya Prabhu. Confirm again. This happens not only to you, to me, to even to senior devotees, sannyasis also. Why? Why does Maya attack at that time? Because Maya Devi knows that he or she chants the holy name nicely, he'll go back to Godhead. He'll be out of my clutches, he'll be out of the jail. So, Maya Devi wants to keep you captivated in this material world. That's why she will lose all tricks at her command to somehow keep you. And that she knows this is the time. If I can just keep him out of chanting for 2 hours, then jail mere. Like you know, in jail, how many of you have been to a jail? In Kolhapur, there's one Kadamba jail. You know Kolhapur? You have been there? No. There, I went there for giving lecture, not for any other reason. So, there in the jail, you know, we had a program at 6 p.m. and all the audience came at 5:30. Just like today we said 6:30. And Prabhuji was saying, keep the time as 7. But I said 6:30 and by 7:15 most of you were here. It's part of ISKCON, otherwise we may lose a reputation. So, but here everybody came at 5:30. They're listening so attentively. And then one of the superintendents showed me, there's one special cell in the jail where those criminals who try to escape, they are put there. It is called Ati Suraksha, heavy security. Why they are put there? Because they were trying to escape and they were caught. See, other prisoners, they have general security. But those who try to escape, the jail keeper keeps special attention on them. The same way, if you are in this material world, just enjoying family life, once a week coming Sunday and you know doing some japa and some pujas and 1,000 rupees for Janmashtami. Maya Devi says, "Are apna hi aadmi hai, khali naam se bolta hai." He's our man, like spy. Like ISI men wandering in India, you know. So he's an opposite party. You know. But when you start chanting seriously, Mayadev is going to high alert, you know, that this fellow is trying to escape. I must try all means, give him nice position, nice family life, nice attractions, that it reduces his chanting. Somehow they distract him. Not only for grihastha, but for brahmacharis also. You may think brahmachari has no distraction, but some distraction, some foolish thing will come. So you have to say yes to Krishna, no to Maya. Whatever Maya Devi says, whatever thought comes, you tell your mind, shut up, shut up. I will do whatever you have done afterwards. If the mind is too turbulent, just take a piece of paper and take a pen and tell to the mind, tell me what all things you want to do. I have to do this, I have to book my ticket, I have to talk, tuck, 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 tuck. Okay, now close it. And then go on chanting. So that's a million-dollar question. How to control the mind? There's some hints Prabhupada is giving here. Okay, any other questions or comments? We'll need a little more. Okay. Now I will come to a next verse. Yam yam vapi smaran bhavam. Tyajati anti kalevaram. Tam tam eveti kaunteya. Sada tadbhava bhavita. Anybody knows the translation of this verse? Please raise your hand if somebody knows the translation. Yes? Sankarshan Nitai Prabhu. What is the translation of this verse? Huh? You should know. Have you read Bhagavad Gita? How many times? Once, yes. You should not read again. It's very dangerous. Any Matajis know? Yam yam vapi smaran bhavam, you know? But tell me in essence. I think you are looking and saying. No? Very good memory. Must be taking almonds every day. You know? Prabhuji spoke perfectly. It looked like he is looking. You know? Whatever state of being one remembers, when you quit the body, that state you attain without fail. What is the example in the Bhagavatam? Whatever you remember, that body you will get? Bharat Maharaj. Bharat Maharaj was a nice devotee. He gave up his family life at a young age and he went to the forest, to Nepal, to do his tapasya and bhajan. When he was chanting, tears were coming out of his eyes. He was shivering in ecstasy. All the symptoms we discussed in the morning, it was practically exhibited by Bharat Maharaj. But yet, he saw a baby deer, with mother deer gave birth and she died. He was thinking, oh, this deer has to be saved. He brought the deer to his ashram. There's nothing wrong so far. But he neglected his own spiritual practices. During Mangal Arati, he was with deer. During Japa, deer. My dear, deer. So he became a deer. So for us also, for grihastha, the husband, wife or children, they become dear. For brahmacharis also, sometimes you become attached to your clothes or to your laptop. Kotha gela mora laptop. I told you this story once, you know, I lost my laptop. Anything you can become attached to. So you have to be very, very cautious. Because I may just suddenly think of something very unwanted and that time the reel may stop. That's finished. However, Prabhupada says that if you have tried sincerely, Krishna will help you. Bharat Maharaj had to go through three births. First he was King Bharat, became Dear Bharat, and then Jad Bharat. So Bharat Maharaj took three births. Now your mind may say, "Arey, itna lamba hai, teen births, Bharat ko lage, apan char mein jayenge. What is the hurry? Remember hurry, no more hurry." But Prabhupada says, if you are trying sincerely, then you can go back to God in one life also. Like Dhruva Maharaj. Dhruva Maharaj went to the forest. Bharat Maharaj went to the forest. But Dhruva Maharaj was more determined. Determination has to be there. What you are thinking of, that is important. Sometimes you may utter Krishna also, but you are thinking of your material attachments, you will take birth again. Yes, Swami Prakash Prabhu, I'd like to speak something about this. Murli Murari Prabhu. You'd like to comment something about this or any, we'll read the next. Prabhupada says, nectar of devotion. Prabhupada says, what is the meaning of perseverance? When a person is undisturbed, even in the presence of various cause of disturbance, he is called reserved and perseverant. Persevering means go on. Like any flight you take, Bombay, Bangalore to Bombay or Delhi, or you'll find there'll be some turbulence. Sometimes it's too much turbulence also, right? But suppose the pilot thinks, anyway there is a lot of turbulence, premanande. That will be the last. It's always, invariably there is some turbulence. So when we are chanting, it's like we are riding, we are the pilot of our lives here, on the order of Prabhupada. And we can't, we have to be perseverance. Perseverance means, if the mind is wandering, just go on chanting, go on chanting, go on chanting. Parikshit Maharaj is saying this, O Brahmanas, now a snake is about to come to kill me, but I am surrendered to you. Let that snake or any creature come. Let my only request is that the last minute I can chant the name of Vishnu. I can chant the name of Krishna. Ante Narayana Smriti. Another example is Ajamil. Ajamil, as you know, he was a good devotee, but somehow or other he became attracted by a prostitute, gave up his married family life and engaged in very obnoxious, sinful ways. But at the time of death, he called out for Nara, because he saw three very fearful looking personalities. What are those three very dangerous looking persons? Yamadutas. Those who have gone know it, where it is. Yamadutas. So, you know, there was a debate. Yamadutas said, we will take. But out of fear of Yamadutas, he called out, Narayan, Narayan. He was not calling for Lakshmi Narayan. He was calling for Ajamil Nandan Narayan. You know. But he got the benefit of doubt. And Yamadutas, Vishnutas, they went to Yamaraj. And Yamaraj said, leave him alone. Give him one more chance. Please bring me those persons who do not chant the holy name, whose head does not bow down. Such people, such persons should be punished. So Ajamil did not chant Krishna's name, thinking of Krishna. But he was chanting, thinking of his son. Still he got the benefit. But he didn't go back to Godhead immediately. He got another chance. See, but it doesn't matter. Even if your chanting is not perfect in one life, Krishna will give you another chance. Said, if somebody while slipping, falls, while walking slips and breaks his bones, or is bitten by a serpent, in that pain he cries out, Krishna, 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 then Krishna will deliver him. Now that prayer comes once again. Letter to Devananda. My dear Krishna, please remind me to always chant your holy name. Do not put me into forgetfulness. You are sitting within my heart, the super soul. You can make me remember you, you can make me forget you. So please do not put me into forgetfulness. Please remind me to always chant. It does not matter if you send me to hellish planet, but remind me to chant Hare Krishna. You see, one thing which is very hope-giving is, even if you are attached to material things, even if your consciousness is not yet clear, Krishna is the examiner. So Krishna may just, when he sees you are chanting very sincerely, you are coming for the lectures on time, or if not on time, at least almost on time. If you are serving the temple, then Krishna will arrange like that, that the time when you are about to leave your body, that thought of Jagannath may come on your mind. You suddenly remember Gauranga of Panchatattva Mayapur. Or you suddenly remember Radha Gopinath, Radha Madhav, Radha Shyam Sundar, your favorite deities. At that time, you are looking, thinking of the deity, and that camera is clicked. Just like I am moving my camera and I just look upon this mridanga and click. So the photo of the mridanga will come. So our life is like a moving reel. And where that final point comes, that will be our destiny. It is said in the Puranas that if one sees Lord Jagannath at the time of Rath Yatra, how many of you have seen Lord Jagannath seated on the Rath? Then such a person, when he leaves his body, at that time that thought of Jagannath will come, and then the click will happen. then definitely go back to God. So Prabhupada is encouraging us that even if you are not able to remember Krishna, in Sri Sampradaya, you know, there's a temple of Sri Rangam, Kanchipuram, and Tirupati, famous three temples. So Ramanujacharya was offering prayers to Lord Varadaraj Swami, and he wanted to know answers to some questions. And one of the questions was about the time of death. So he asked the Lord, and the Lord replied that even if my devotee, who has done very sincere service throughout his life, even if at the time of death he does not remember me, still I will take him back to God. Now you may think, Prabhuji, it's contradicting Bhagavad Gita. Gita mein bol rahe hain ki jo hoga wo dekha hai, wohi milega. Aur yahan pe, that's like Krishna may give special mercy. Like general price is there, but now big billion sale is coming. You know, so everything is 10% or 20% discount. Special devotee, Krishna may be very pleased. Okay, he is serving my devotees. Even if he has got material desire, even if he is still attached, I will take care of him. His account doesn't matter. But that should not encourage you to forget Krishna. Okay, Prabhuji, now I am doing service. You should try our best, but Krishna is with you. He is a very lenient teacher. Okay, we are coming close to the end. We have 10 minutes more left. Any questions? Are you able to appreciate this, or shall I change my style, or is it okay? Please feel free to give me feedback so that, or you can give after the lecture. You know, suppose you may not like to tell in publicly, you may write and give some suggestions, because the first time I am trying here, this 3 days classes. Once we did Ramayana like this 3 days, there was very good response also. Any other comments or questions? Okay, we'll go to the next. Prabhupada writes here, at the time of death, one's body becomes deteriorated. The brain, many times the brain doesn't function properly. And the bodily organs, they are not working. Kidneys, sometimes liver problem, sometimes stomach disorders. It is said that anybody who has chanted throughout his life, even he cannot chant very clearly at the time of death. I have seen many devotees, Prabhupada disciples, who left their bodies in Vrindavan. Last 1 or 2 weeks of their life, they cannot chant 16 rounds, even though they are sincere. But Krishna, he sees, yes, he is sincere, so he will give concession. So Prabhupada says, while the body is fit, we should chant loudly and distinctly. The two words, very important. It should be distinct. Distinct means, we should not try to merge words like Hare Krishna 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 Hare Krishna 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 Radhani Japa, you know. Just like sometimes doctors have handwriting which they cannot understand also, you know? Only they can understand, you know. Our doctors and MRs, they have got relation, they can understand. So our chanting should be very clear. Clear means Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram Hare. And distinct, there should be a mild gap. So that when we are chanting, it should be like a calling the Lord. Just like, you know, my dear friend Nandanacharya Prabhu is inviting me to his home for many months now. So suppose Prabhuji says, please come to my home. Oh no, I am busy, I'll try next time. Next time again, please come. If he says again and again with great sincerity, so then I will get convinced, yes, I must go. But suppose he says, Prabhuji, I will call you 3 times. Please come, please come, please come. Okay. I have done my job. Now if you don't come, I will be happy. If you come, I will tolerate like that. You know? So then I say, what is the use? So when somebody is chanting with feeling, Hare Krishna, when will I meet you? When will I be with you? Krishna becomes pleased. He will come. Somebody is chanting, Hare Krishna, costume. 8:39, 6 minutes left, one mala. So, and then as soon as 16th hour, I am so happy, I am liberated from chanting. So Krishna will say that he is not chanting, he is simply counting. And this happens to me also, because we all have to have practical schedules, so we do have to calculate. I am not against looking at the watch, but along with looking at the watch, we have to look at the heart also. Our chanting should be like that, like calling. Then you will feel happy to chant for hours together, because you are feeling some connection with the Lord. It is not mechanical, but it's actually praying. Like when a child cries, it's not that he has a formula, I will cry, The child cries, he'll cry. The same example I was telling in the Vrindavan, the other elder child, he was watching a small video. It was 9:30 in the night, and the mother took away the mobile and he started crying like anything. They got tantrums, like falling to the ground, breaking his head, touching the anything he will do to get. So then the mother has to say, okay, take it. That way we have to cry to Krishna, beg Krishna, fall at the feet of the holy name. Please, Krishna, please, please, please give me pure devotion. Please give me your service. Then Krishna will give. Okay. In one more paragraph we will conclude. Prabhupada writes here, Devi esha gunamai mama maya duratyaya mamaya prapadyante maya metam taranti. This material energy is very difficult to overcome, but one who remembers me, one who chants my name, he can easily overcome. When Prabhupada was very sick in Vrindavan, they called many doctors, vaidyas. Prabhupada would consult them, but sometimes he would take medicine, sometimes he would not take. Then he would say, the real medicine is the holy name. This Mahamantra should go on. Before going to America, Prabhupada was doing a business as a pharmacy shop. You know, where was this place? Prayag. Yeah, now Prayag, yes, Allahabad. And Prabhupada had a pharmacy shop. And he told his godbrother, Mr. OBL Kapoor, he told, now I am selling these medicines. It is the medicine of the drugs, medicine, like kerosene and others. But one day I will market those medicine which can eradicate all suffering. That is the holy name of God. Then he said, in order to take this medicine properly, you have to take another medicine with it. Like, you know, in medical science, you take one medicine with it. So along with Hare Krishna mantra, one has to take another medicine, and that is Trinadapi, Chitunichena, Tarorapi, Saishna. Of course, Panchatattva also. But here Prabhupada says Trinadapi, Sunichena. We should take this medicine also. Then we can be assured of success. Tomorrow morning we will discuss this point in detail. How to take shelter with a humble heart. Prabhupada says, gives another example. He says, King Kulashekhar. You know this prayer of King Kulashekhar? Anybody knows the Sanskrit? You know that verse? King Kulashekhar? Huh? Krishna Tvadiya Prisya Krishna Tvadiya Padapanjarantam Adyevame Vishayamanasa Rajahansa Prana Pranaya Samaye Kafavata Patte Kantavarodhana Smaranam Kutas. This was a very favorite prayer. So Prabhupada says in this lecture that we should remember this prayer. That now let my mind, which is like a Rajahansa, enter into your lotus feet. Because the time of death, Kafavata Pitta Irkanta, my whole body will be choked up. I may not be able to remember you. So now let me leave my body, remembering your lotus feet. Prabhupada was once giving lecture in Vrindavan. This was on December 2nd. 1975, the same year when the DTs were installed in April 75. 6 months after installation or 8 months after installation, he was giving a lecture. He said, chanting of Hare Krishna would be done in what attitude? Please listen. Death is coming, death is coming, death is at my door. Let me finish my chanting. So let me chant. Shripad Aindra Prabhu, Prabhupada disciple, he says, when you are chanting the mantra on a bead, you should think that this is the last bead. So with that intensity, we should chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. And then when that bead gets over, you should think this is the next last bead, and the last bead. And one of the beads will be the last bead. So in that mood, we should try to chant the holy name. Okay, we have 2 minutes for any questions or comments, and then we'll do kirtan for 5-10 minutes. Any comments? Tomorrow morning, please try to come for Mangal Arati, and then we'll chant together from 5:30 to 7:30. Hopefully, we can finish 16 rounds. Then Guru Puja and class, How many of you would like to join for chanting after Bhagavatam? How many of you feel you have the time and inclination tomorrow after Bhagavatam? After Bhagavatam, we give a little break for breakfast and then chanting, or chanting and then breakfast? Huh? Or should we cancel the class and just have chanting? Huh? How many would like just chanting? Or maybe half an hour class, half an hour chanting? Because after breakfast, I doubt whether how many will stay. Breakfast prasad means end of program. Anyway, tomorrow we will decide depending on the desire of the devotee. I am open for both options. Or what we could do is we could chant and after breakfast we can have class. But it is my desire that we try for 64 rounds. At least if I say 64, I am sure you will all be able to do at least 32 or 40 rounds. We should try for more and more. Okay? So now the last kirtan we would like to do, as I told about this Mataji, and also in this world, you know, so many devotees have so many difficulties, and the prayers of devotees always help. Gopinath Prabhu. Mother is recovering now? Recovering. His mother also went through some fracture and recovering. His wife also, Mataji also, such a great encouragement. I saw her come to the temple and the prasad hall, you know, walking is not so easy. Actually, I saw Prabhuji, I didn't say, I thought that she will not come, she has a problem, but still, this is also preaching, setting an example. And I went through heart surgery, and after the heart surgery, you know how the atmosphere in the hospital is. Very few people like to be, suppose you are given free admission in the hospital for 1 month, still nobody would like to stay. So I also wanted to run away. But my Guru Maharaj, Adhanath Maharaj, told you stay. And then somehow that I convinced the doctor to get discharged early. But still I had to stay for some time. So. And Maharaj was very happy that yes, should be eager to hear and chant. Just see, the clock is 8:46 and what is the date today? 20th September 2019. Just change 2019 to 2099 or 89. How many of you will be here? Maybe this watch may survive. I doubt that also. You know. But most of us will not be there. At least I will not be there. Maximum after 10 years to 12 years. So you'll always think like that. Then your chanting will improve. Srila Satsarup Maharaj, you know, wrote this book, Lilamrit. He asked direct question to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, I want to make rapid spiritual advancement. What shall I do? And you know what Prabhupada replied? He said, just think that today is the last. So please, let us chant just 5 minutes of kirtan in that mood of crying out like Draupadi, like Gajendra, begging to be connected with Krishna through transcendental sound vibration. We'll do sitting kirtan only so that it's a little grave.